Namaskar, myself Pratik. In this session, we are going to discuss the concept of explicit cursor. Let us start this session. We have already discussed that there are two types of cursors. One is implicit cursor and second is explicit cursor. Implicit cursors are created implicitly by Oracle server whenever we execute an DML statement in PLSQL. The name of implicit cursor is SQL, and we have already discussed the use of implicit cursor. In this session, we are going to discuss the need and usage of explicit cursor with examples. As we have already discussed that cursor is a memory or work area that Oracle engine uses for its internal processing for executing and storing the results of SQL statement. This work area is used for all SQL operations, and we call this work area as cursor. For example, when a user fire a select statement, select column name from table name, where condition, then all the rows returned by the query are stored in the cursor, and then the rows returned by this query is displayed to the client end. It means when we execute a select statement, the rows returned by the processing of this statement is stored in a cursor, and we can use the cursor to process one row at a time. As we have already discussed, implicit cursors are declared by PLSQL implicitly for all SQL statements. They are opened and managed by Oracle engine internally. So there is no need to open and manage implicit cursor by the programmer. All the operations performed by Oracle automatically in case of implicit cursor. But in case of explicit cursor, a programmer has to perform all the operations. In case of explicit cursor, a programmer has to perform four main operations. The first operation is to declare the cursor in the declare section. And to declare the cursor in the declare section, we have to use the syntax cursor, cursor name is select statement. Here cursor name is the user defined name. And the rows returned by the execution of this select statement is stored in this user-defined cursor. The second step will be to open the cursor in the begin section. And to open the cursor, the syntax is open cursor name. The third step in the handling of explicit cursor is to fetch the data from the cursor one row at a time into the memory variables. And to fetch the data from the cursor one row at a time, we have to use fetch statement with the syntax fetch cursor name into variables. Here cursor name is the name of user defined cursor, and the value of the columns fetched by this cursor will be stored in these variables. It is important to note that we have to declare these variables in the declare section. Since this fetch statement fetch one row at a time, so we have to process the data of all the rows of cursor. We have to use this fetch statement in a loop so that the value of all the rows stored in this cursor can be fetched and stored in these variables for its processing. It is important to note that we have to exit from the loop after processing is complete. So the third step will be to use fetch statement in a loop to fetch one row of a cursor at a time into these variables. The fourth and final step will be to close the cursor. And the syntax to close the cursor is close cursor name. So we can conclude that to use explicit cursor, a programmer has to first declare the cursor in the declare section by using the statement cursor cursor name is select statement. Then programmer has to open this cursor in the begin section by using the statement open cursor name. Then the loop will be constructed to fetch one row of a cursor at a time into the memory variables. And after the processing of all the rows of the cursor, we will exit from the loop. And the fourth and final step will be to close the cursor by using the statement close cursor name. We have to use open, fetch and close statements in the begin section, while this cursor should be declared in the declare section by using statement cursor cursor name is select statement. This is all about this session. In next video session, we will perform all these steps to implement the concept of explicit cursor in an example code. To read more about this, you can refer my book Simplified Approach to DBMS, which is available on Amazon. You are requested to subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive latest video tutorials on topics like data mining, machine learning, DBMS, big data, NoSQL, and many more. To learn SQL in a simplified way, you can join this free online course on SQL at Udemy platform. I have also authored books on data mining and data warehousing, NoSQL, beginning with SQL, and PL SQL for beginners. All these books are available on Amazon platform. To read more about this, you can refer my website pratikbhatia.com. Thanks for watching this video.